Hello, everybody. My name is Zohir Chaudhary, and today we'll talk about environmental risk transition. The term environmental risk transition characterizes changes in environmental risks that happen as a consequence of economic development in the less developed regions of the world. During development, societies tend to push off environmental problems from local to global scales. Household hazards dominate in the poorest parts of the world as those countries struggle with inadequate food, poor air, and water quality, leading to widespread diarrhea, asthma, malaria, and malnutrition. During the transition, as countries reach middle-income status through industrialization, environmental risks shift towards industrial and vehicular pollution. After the transition, problems of household risks are brought under control and community risks from industrial and vehicular pollution starts to diminish. But then a new type of risk emerge at the global level in the form of increasing level of greenhouse gas. Such global risks are shared by all countries because of its global nature. The environmental risk transition curves shown here should not be considered fixed in the sense that today's developing nations will be forced to go through them in the same way that today's industrialized countries have done in the past to reach where they are. Rather, the curves should be viewed as a management framework by which to judge the progress of development policy. The task in developing countries is to avoid the excess of the past, the excesses of the past, to continue to push down the household curve and to not let the community curve rise out of hand. This might be considered a kind of tunneling through the curves to avoid climbing over the peaks by applying cleaner, more efficient energy supply and use technologies earlier in the development process than what has occurred to date. In here, we see an example of environmental risk transition. For in the US in the 1900, average life expectancy was only 47 years. And by the year 2000, this almost doubled to 77 years. And this happened mostly due to greatly reduced mortality from infectious diseases. And that happened because of improved sanitation, improved nutrition, improved work environment, as well as less number of children. So our critical thinking questions: why do developing countries suffer far more problems associated with environmental degradation than do developed countries? Think about this and write your answers down.